everybody. Welcome back to another awesome day, another awesome vlog. Today, I am going to talk to you about the Disneyland app. I actually use the Disneyland app every single time we go to Disneyland. So I kind of wanted to talk to you about it, show you how to use it, show you some of the in and outs and some of the amazing things about it. But before I do, I wanted to tell you, thank you so much for all of your support. Bill and I are so thankful. We have really, really noticed so much growth in our channel lately. We've had a lot more views, a lot more subscribers, a lot more likes on our videos. And that's all because of you guys. And we are so thankful for you. If it weren't for you, we wouldn't have anyone to watch our videos on our channel. And we are so thankful for all of you out there. And we just wanted to let you know that we do notice and we really are very appreciative. So we just wanted to make sure to tell you that before we moved forward with this video today. So now let's get started on the Disneyland app. The first thing you're gonna do is go into your app store and you're going to download the Disneyland app. It's totally free. There's no charge for it. And as soon as you get it installed and opened, you're going to want to set up a login and a password so that when you start using this, you're gonna wanna have your own login because there are certain things inside the park that you can't do unless you're actually logged in. When you open the app, at the top, there's going to be a section that looks like Disneyland, and just below that, there's going to be a button that says sign in. That's the button that you're gonna wanna click first thing, and you're going to wanna create a login and a password. It's very, very easy, and then every time, as soon as you get to Disneyland and open your app, you're going to wanna go ahead and sign in and be signed into your app all day so that you are ready to use all of the features that they have available. Once you've signed in, you are going to see that there are so many different things that you can do on this app. If you scroll down from the homepage a little bit, you're going to see that there is information about Star Wars Land. If you click on the button to find out more information about Star Wars Land, you're going to find that Star Wars Land is either open or they are accepting reservations. Most of the time, they're going to just be open, but on extra busy days, you may have to sign up for a time to return and come to Star Wars Land during certain hours. This is called a boarding group. So there are certain times that you may have to click to press to join a boarding group. But as you can see from the picture that I have up here, there's no boarding group necessary. Star Wars Land is just open and anyone can come and go as they please. I will tell you that we've been there multiple times since Star Wars Land has been open and never has it been necessary to join a boarding group. We've been there on really, really busy days and slower days and it's still never been necessary. As you scroll down within the Star Wars Land section, you'll also see that it'll show you how long the wait is for the Millennium Falcon, and it'll also prompt you to the Play app, which is a Disneyland app that will allow you to play different things throughout the park. I've shown you a video on that in the past, so if you haven't seen it, feel free to look back for the Disneyland Play app video that I've done, but it is really, really fun. There are different places and different things that you can do within the park. Sometimes when you're waiting in line for a different ride, I know one of them is Peter Pan. They have a lot of interactive things, especially for kids to keep them busy while they're waiting. Let's go back to the homepage. To do that, all you have to do at the very bottom of the app on the left-hand side is a little house, and if you click on that, it'll always take you right back to the homepage. At the very top of the app where I indicated there was a section that looked like Disneyland, if you tap that, it will open up the park. And this is the most amazing section there is. So this works for Disneyland and California Adventure. And it's really amazing because first of all, what shows up immediately when you have this section open are the attractions. It will show you every attraction and the current wait time. We have found that every once in a while, these are off slightly. They just haven't quite updated them if they get an influx of people all of a sudden. But for the most part, the ride time frames are very, very accurate. So you can move this around and scroll around and you can see exactly what the wait is for the ride that you want to go on. In this section, you also can click on a ride. So for example, if I click on Star Tours, because Star Tours is a ride that I know has a fast pass, you wanna make sure that you get the max pass, especially if you are only going to be in Disneyland for one day. It is an additional $15 a day, but it is worth it because it allows you to get your fast passes for rides on the app, which saves you the time of having to walk to the kiosk outside the ride, get a return time, and then have to come back. The problem with that is sometimes your return time is an hour or two later. You then have to leave the area, go do something else, and then come all the way back. So this saves you a lot of time. You can then get a max pass, and while you're in line for the ride that you used the fast pass for, you then can get another fast pass for another ride. It really makes your day so much more efficient, and the Max Pass is worth it. So then if you click like I did on Star Tours, this is what comes up and it gives you the option to request a Fast Pass. When you click on that, it gives you a list of all of the people that you have linked passes on your app. I'm gonna show you how to link passes here in a moment as well. But at this point, you can pick who you wanna get fast passes for. You can either get them for everyone in your party, or you can only get them for certain people in your party, which is really great and efficient. The other thing that's really great is at the top, there's a drop-down. The drop-down also shows other things such as entertainment, which will then allow you to see different areas of the park and different entertainment times. So for example, the Disneyland band, when they're gonna play and where they're going to be playing so that you can plan your day appropriately. It also shows restaurants. And the thing that's really great about this is when it shows you the restaurants, as you can see in this picture, there are some restaurants that are just a fork and a knife, but there are others that have a square that look like a cell phone. Those restaurants are the ones that allow mobile ordering. And mobile ordering is amazing. Even if it's not a busy day, we always use mobile ordering. Mobile ordering is very, very simple. You're going to pick the restaurant that you want to order from. It then pulls up a list of everything on their menu. You can choose the item that you want to purchase. It does give you options. So for example, if they have multiple sides available, like French fries or fruit, you can choose which one you want, add it, purchase it, and then there's a separate window that you go to in order to pick your food up. When you do this, you do not have to wait in line. You pay on the app, and you don't have to wait in line when you go get your food. There are times that we have ordered on the app, and when we got to the restaurant, the line is out the door and people are gonna be waiting in line for 45 minutes to an hour simply to order their food. And when we walk through the door, we are already ready to pick up our food. We can just walk right up to the window, give them our name and our order number, pick our food up and be on our way and eating, and it saves so much time. The other thing that's really great about that is if people want to order food, if you have a large group and people are wanting to order food from multiple places, you don't have to wait in line at several different restaurants in order to get everyone what they want. On the mobile app, you can place the order and then just go pick them all up and everyone can eat together. It's quick and easy. In order to link your passes so that you can use the app for getting fast passes for everyone in your group, you're simply gonna click the button on the bottom right-hand corner. It is three little lines. That is going to pull up a section that's going to allow you to add anyone that you want in your party into this app. You're simply gonna click the button that says tickets and passes, and then it is going to prompt you to scan the ticket that you have for this person for the day and put a name with it. This is really great, especially for annual pass holders like Bill and I and my mom and dad, because we go together a lot and it saves everyone in my phone. So when we're together, I can simply open the app, get passes for all of us for a ride, and it's quick and easy. I don't have to scan our passes in every time. They're already automatically saved there. It makes it so much easier when we want to get a fast pass for a ride. And it's really, really simple, like I just showed you, to add somebody and to scan their pass in. It's really, really user friendly. The other thing that's really great about the mobile app and having the Max Pass is there are characters all over, and they're very easy to find by using the app. If you go to the section with the picture of Disneyland and at the top you do the drop down and choose characters, it will show you where characters will be throughout the park, what times they will be there. Of course, there are other characters that are just out wandering around at random times and they're not always easy to find, but you just bump into them. If there is a Disneyland photographer there, which there are certain areas of the park that there always are, for example, in front of the castle, but there are also Disneyland photographers available with some of the characters. When you get there, they take pictures and their pictures are professional and they are really, really beautiful. When you're finished, they can scan either your app or your pass and they are automatically linked to the app if your pass is linked to your app. The thing that's really great about that is you can immediately download them, you can keep them, and there is no charge for downloading them. If you don't have a Max Pass and pictures are taken, you have to purchase them. So this is really amazing, especially if you are going with your family and want to take the time to wait for some of the characters and take some really great pictures. These are going to be nice enough pictures that you can blow them up and put them on your wall. And there's no charge for them. It's part of the Max Pass. When you have the app, it's really easy. As you can see, these are some pictures that Bill and I took a while ago at Disneyland, and they're still saved here. They keep them in the app available for 1 year, but they're very, very easy to just download even from the app onto your phone and then send to your computer. And then you can either send them in to be printed or print them at home. And the pictures, like I said, they really are amazing. If you go back to the home page and scroll down a little bit, there's also going to be a button that says show times. If you click on this, it's going to show you all of the major shows, parades, fireworks, things like that, that are taking place in Disneyland and California Adventure on the day that you are there. It's going to give you the location and the time so that you, once again, can easily and efficiently plan your day. It's also going to give you the park hours, and it's going to give you the option of choosing different days in the next couple of weeks if you want to look at those days, the hours of operation, and shows that may be playing on those days in case you're at the park for multiple days in a row. Of course, there's also always information about shops and shopping. There are so many different shops available and different items available to purchase from Disneyland if you're looking for the special souvenir before you leave for the day. And the app will give you all of this information as well. If you head back to the home page, and if you go up to the top to the Disneyland pictured section, there's going to be a drop down for shops. It is then going to give you information about each and every shop. All you have to do is click on the button with the little shopping bag on it, open it up, see what shop it is, and if it's something that you're interested in going to. So at the end of the day, when you're tired and you and your kids are looking for a souvenir, you can easily look for a shop that's on your way out of the park and just plan your route out, head into that shop, get souvenirs for everyone, and head on out for the day. So I hope you enjoyed this video. The Disneyland app is simply amazing. It is something that I use, like I said, every single time we go to Disneyland. It helps us plan our day efficiently and get so much stuff done, even in the short periods of time when we go for just a quick visit. So I highly recommend using the Disneyland app. I highly recommend getting a Max Pass, especially if you're only going to be there for 1 or 2 days, to get as much in as possible and to be able to get your Fast Passes from the app right on your phone. Once again, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to smash the thumbs up button. Don't forget to subscribe. And again, thank you guys so much for your support. We love you all.